So Meghna, I want to ask you, you're heading one of the best institutes in India and overseas also. It is a film institute, but you get students who are from all walks of life. So basically, I want to address the question of students. How do they handle success, failure? Because there are so many ups and downs going in their lives. So how does one handle these things? You're a senior, but how do the students handle these?
So first of all, there's this stereotype attached to our industry, I know everyone here will know about it, that there is a lot of struggle in the industry, and it's not really a stereotype. There is struggle because it's and I feel that there is struggle everywhere. It's just that here there are passionate individuals out there to do what they really love. So there's struggle first at the family level, where family doesn't want to allow them to pursue what they want to do. Then there's struggle, of course, when they go out, because there's a lot of competition, and how do they actually get out there and showcase their talent. So when we started Whistling Woods, the main vision that we had was that, you know, there are hundreds and thousands of lakhs of people, talented young individuals, who are leaving their homes every day, walking into Mumbai to make a career into this film industry. And most of them go back home depressed, with nothing in hand. And we felt very strongly that, you know, just like every other profession, every talented individual must have the opportunity to train themselves. Why is it that in filmmaking and the creative arts, we believe that the training is not important? Of course it is. Are you telling me that a doctor, a really good doctor, is not talented? Of course they are. And there are so many people who go to medical school. But why is it that there are some doctors who are just, you know, we call them magicians? So I think that it's the training that is really important. So even if you have the skill, if you're born with it, you need to hone that skill. So that is when we decided to start Whistling Woods, and it was a big decision on our part, because, like, you know, talking about mental health here, people with creative minds are generally more right brain, yeah? And in the right brain, then there's a lot of creativity, but there's also a lot of insecurities, a lot of fears, and various other kinds of emotional problems. So when we started Whistling Woods, and me being a very left brain person, I had to deal with lots of right brain people, including the faculty, you know, who were very creative. They were creative professionals, the students. So any kind of problem that would occur, I was the only left brain person left there to handle this. So I have really studied creative people over the last 12 years, and I've realized that it is a challenge for them, because, you know, they are really, really passionate about what they want to do, and they feel like the whole world is trying to stop them from doing it. So the more we support them as families, as friends, the better it is for them. They do go through a lot of issues, and this, I think, is widespread. I don't think it's only in the creative schools. Any college, any university, any school, you see how much pressure our children are dealing with. Social media does not help, you know. People put out there all the good things that they're doing, but they don't put out there what struggles they're going through to get there. And children at that age are too naive to actually understand that. So all across, the youth is struggling with this. There are a lot of issues that they have to grapple with. But at Whistling Woods, we've made a conscious effort to make sure that we are all there as support for them, whether it's the faculty. So our students have a great rapport with their faculty members. One big advantage is that they are themselves from the industry. So they know the struggles of the industry, and they can actually forewarn the students, ki, be careful, this might come your way. And when that happens, they've also experienced it themselves. So there's a level of empathy where they can actually take the students through those problems. Second, we do a lot of sports. I feel that, you know, to really, you know, think in the positive direction, even though we are a creative school, it is really important to have some form of physical fitness, physical exercise out there. So we do a lot of competition. We have cricket matches, we have football, and, you know, many a times people are like, you're a film school, students hardly have time, but this is really important as well. Their challenges that they face over the 3 years, whether it's coursework challenge, whether it's them comparing themselves. See, when they join Whistling Woods, they all think, humko Whistling Woods mein admission mil gayi, I must be the best. But when they see the work of their colleagues and their other friends, then they start getting insecure, saying, oh my God, I'm not even close. So that then sets in. However, it's our role to mentor them, and which is what we really focus on. the mentorship of each and every student that there is at Whistling Woods. So for us, it's very important to mentor them well, to make sure that they're engaged creatively. And eventually, at the end of the third year, we find 99% of them actually end up taking all their insecurities, all their fears, and beautifully displaying it through their music or through their art form or through their films. So I feel that somewhere we are doing something right. It is very, very challenging. As generations come along, it's becoming more and more challenging. But I think there are these things that we do, and we might have to reinvent ourselves to keep thinking of what else. But these are the things that we are doing at the moment.
Great, great, wonderful. So if you have to give pointers to parents or other institutes on what are the best practices they could use to bring out the best in their children or have their children well balanced, emotionally, mentally, spiritually.
One of the most beautiful videos that I've seen is, I don't know if you've seen it, it comes on WhatsApp often, it's about the fish in a bowl and how we're trying to get the fish to climb a tree. So if we just understand that principle of nature, that not everybody can be an engineer, not everybody can be a doctor or a journalist or a filmmaker even, but let's actually just look at each child as an individual, I feel we're halfway there. I feel that we must just look at our children. Sadhguru, somebody I listen to a lot, and he also says in his videos, he says, your children are not yours to own. You don't own them. They're individuals. They have come with their own destiny. They've come with their own talent, and you must just own that. So as parents, I know I'm a parent of two children, and I know how extremely difficult it is for me not to overpower them with personality traits that I have, and I want them to have those traits. But you have to hold yourself back, and especially when it comes to exams and it comes to pressure, it's not necessary that every child is going to excel at math, And if you see your child being creative, one of the biggest complaints I have about our education system is that we are so amazing when it comes to creativity and drawing and art and dance, singing, up till the age of 12. After that, everything becomes secondary. And then you start focusing on your exams. But that's just when the child has started to learn about that art form. Then what, right? So I feel that at that point, we must not stop. We must continue those art forms. We must continue to let them explore. I missed your point. So I feel that, if we just don't stop there, we will make a huge difference. And last point that I want to mention here is that creativity and any kind of art form or any kind of talent that any person possesses, even if they become the prime minister of this country or they become a doctor or an engineer, that will always take them a long way. When a stressed out lawyer comes back home after a long day and he just has a canvas to paint on, it's a stress buster. So let's actually just really let our children explore in the creative fields, whether they take it up as a profession or not. There's no harm done.
So that is what we've been discussing over here. The whole focus of this discussion, how to navigate life skillfully, is our schools and colleges are all the time talking about how to make more money, grooming the child to make more money, but nobody's teaching them the basic life skills. So we thought this panel discussion, we would bring out the various perspectives from various people, and then we can kind of collate it and put it out to the people. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.